So you bought a fresh new t-shirt. But as usual, you can never find one that fits perfectly. Maybe it's too big in the sleeves, or too baggy in the waist. Or maybe it's just too long and it feels like you're wearing a dress. Not to worry guys, Thomas with Real Men Real Style here. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make your t-shirt fit you perfectly. No sewing machine required. Here's what you need to get started. A sewing needle. Find a thread color that closely matches the fabric of your t-shirt. Sewing pins. Safety pins. Fabric pencil or chalk. A ruler. Scissors and an iron. Step number one, measure and pin. We need to figure out how much fabric we need to take in. The first and easiest method is if you already have a perfect fitting t-shirt, you can use it as a template. Turn your t-shirt inside out and lay it on a flat surface. Then take your perfect fitting t-shirt and lay it on top. Line up the top of the shoulders, then go ahead and mark along the edges with your fabric pencil. If you're only bringing in the waist, make sure to taper it into the armpit. Cutting in sharply will leave a nasty looking dimple. You want a smooth transition. The same applies if you're only tailoring the sleeves. If you're slimming both the waist and the sleeves, you can continue the line through the armpit without tapering. Once you're done marking, put sewing pins in to hold the fabric in place. Now, if you don't have that perfect fitting shirt to use as a template, you can get the measurements for yourself. Turn the t-shirt inside out and put it on. For the waist, pinch the fabric at your sides until it fits as closely as you'd like, then secure it with a safety pin. Continue pinning all the way from the bottom of the hem up to the armpit. If you're slimming the arm, repeat the same process. Make sure you've taken in an equal amount from both sides. If you're going to be shortening the shirt, you can use a ruler to figure out the right measurement. The correct length for a t-shirt will be 2 to 3 inches below your belt line. Make a note of the measurement you took, take off the shirt, and lay it down flat. Now take your fabric pencil and trace a line along the safety pins. Remove the safety pins and replace them with sewing pins. For the hem, use the measurement you took and mark it with your fabric pencil. Then draw a horizontal line across. Bring up the bottom of the t-shirt hem so it folds along the line you just drew. Now take the fabric and fold it in half. If you have too much fabric to do this, use your scissors to trim off the excess. Take your iron and press the fold flat. Then pin it in place. Now it's time to start sewing. Cut 3 to 4 feet of thread. We're gonna double thread the needle for maximum strength. Pull the thread through the needle and make sure both ends are equal in length. We're going to create a knot by wrapping the thread around your index finger to make an X. Pinch the X between your index finger and thumb, then slide your index finger back, letting the thread roll forward. Bring your middle finger down in front to hold it before pulling the thread with your other hand. This leaves you with a strong knot that won't come loose. We're going to start sewing the waist and sleeve first, then tackle the hem. Secure your thread to the shirt by using your needle to grab a couple threads from the t-shirt, pull the needle through, then do it again to create a loop. Bring the needle through the loop and pull it tight to form a knot. Now we're ready to sew all the way down the length of the waist and the sleeve. For maximum strength, we're going to use a backstitch. Basically, each stitch will form a complete loop. So on one side of the fabric, you're going to go 2 stitch lengths, push the needle through to the other side, then loop back 1 stitch length before pushing it through to the original side. Then you just repeat the same process. 2 stitch lengths forward, 1 stitch length back. It's a bit time consuming, but it's going to give you a very strong stitch that won't rip apart on you later. You'll likely run out of thread before you reach the end. No worries, simply secure the thread with a knot like you did at the beginning, forming a loop and pulling the needle through. Then rethread your needle and keep going. Continue stitching until you reach the end, then secure your thread with 1 final knot. Take your scissors and trim away the excess fabric, leaving between 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch of seam allowance. Although knit fabric won't fray like woven fabric will, I still like to secure the edges so they will lay more neatly. To do this, we're going to use a whip stitch. Unlike the back stitch that has you pushing through both sides of the fabric, the whip stitch only goes through one side, then loops over the edge. Secure the stitch with a knot at the start, then continue down the length of the fabric edge. Finish with another knot once you reach the end. Now let's tackle sewing the hem. Turn the shirt right side out. You want to focus on the outside so you can make the stitch as clean as possible. I like to mark a line on the outside of the shirt. This acts as a guide so I can make sure my stitches are straight. I have a 1-inch hem, so I'm going to make my stitch 1/8 of an inch from the top edge. Go ahead and make a knot on the inside of the shirt, then go along the entire length of the hem using the back stitch. Take your time. Since the stitch is going to be visible, you want to make it as even as possible. Once you get to the end, make 1 final knot and you're done. Now give the hem a quick press with the iron and you're set. Now you can make any t-shirt fit you perfectly. Never settle for a mediocre fit again. Did you know you can also tailor your pants to fit better too? Check out this video, gents. where I show you how to hem and slim your trousers. No sewing machine required.